I'm Yoav Potash, and I am the producer and director of the documentary Crime After Crime, which follows the legal battle to free Deborah Peagler. Deborah was an incarcerated survivor of domestic violence, sentenced to life in prison for her connection to the murder of the man who abused her. And 20 years later, two attorneys volunteer to fight to try to get Deborah out of prison and reinvestigate the case. I heard about Deborah's story from Joshua Saffron, one of the two attorneys who did volunteer to try to get Deborah out of prison. And I didn't commit to making the film right away. Once I met Deborah, however, and filmed an interview with her, then I was hooked. So I felt that she had a great contrast that would be very dynamic for audiences to experience in a documentary film. So I thought it would only take about a year, but due to all the twists and turns in the case, which turned out to be very unpredictable, it took 5.5 years to complete the film, but it was completed at the beginning of this year, and we premiered it at the Sundance Film Festival, have since taken it to many film festivals, and are now bringing it to movie theaters, including here at the West End Cinema in Washington, D.C. So Deborah's lawyers are actually land use attorneys by day, and therefore civil attorneys. They don't have experience with criminal defense or criminal law, and yet they're the ones who step forward to represent Deborah because no one else would. She would have had no representation at all. So in that sense, for me as a storyteller, I see them as fish out of water. And that, again, makes an interesting and compelling story for an audience to experience. We can all relate to the idea of being a little in over your head on something that's very important and perhaps with even high stakes. And for them, the stakes are very high. Someone's freedom, someone's life is on the line. And yet they're wading into a world that's completely foreign to them. Unfortunately, Deborah's case is not entirely unique. The vast majority of women who are in prison today experienced domestic violence or rape or abuse or incest at some point in their lives. And for many of them, that's what led them down the path that eventually put them in prison. And only recently have courts begun to realize that those cases are different from other murder cases, that if someone is abusing a woman chronically, day after day after day, year after year after year, that is a different circumstance. But unfortunately, it takes a great deal of legal wrangling and even public battling in the media and through grassroots advocacy for someone like Deborah to really have a chance at freedom. Alongside the film, we have launched a project called Debbie's Campaign, which is all about maximizing the impact of the film to help change the current state of domestic violence law in the United States.